Welcome back to Out of the Blue. I'm Andrew Ottman. Dr. Katie Schrodt is a professor in our College of Education. She is also a vocal advocate on family literacy. She recently received a grant to engage community schools in literacy events, and she works to underscore how high-quality, culturally sustaining books can make a big difference in the development of our children. And she joins us on Out of the Blue to talk about this and some amazing news. Welcome to Out of the Blue.
Thank you so much. Thank you for having me.
So, appreciate it. Congratulations on this grant. Why don't you talk a little bit about what that means, the organization First Book, and what that money is going to help you accomplish?
Yes, so I'm really excited because this is my first big grant to get. I got $50,000 and it's all books from First Book. And what First Book is, it's a nonprofit, and they really seek to close the achievement gap for students of low-income families. And right. So the reason they're called First Book is they hope to be a child's first book.
Okay, so very literally, yes. It is a first book.
Yeah,
okay.
And so they can, and not just like any book that came from your trash bin that somebody donated, but a brand new award-winning, culturally relevant book that can be theirs. And so what they do is they help teachers who work with low-income students, and they help families by providing books that are high quality, award winning, mm-hmm. culturally sustaining for about $5 a piece, which never happens. And I brought some beautiful ones here to see.
And that's a good segue. These look very attractive and very impressive just for judging the book by the cover, but obviously this fits the bill, what you're looking for, right?
Yes, and so just as a short example, this book, Dreamers, is the author, it's her true story. Of how when she crossed the border with her child on her hip from Mexico into El Paso, and she tells a story about how they found libraries for the first time, and it was like a magical place for her. And she learned how to speak English, learned her artwork, and that's her true story, and it's award-winning, Pura Belpre Award. Mm-hmm. And when I open a box from First Book, it's my breath is taken away because of the art. And these kids will feel the same.
Gorgeous.
They'll feel the same way when, and then they get to own that and keep it.
Mm-hmm. Absolutely gorgeous. Mm-hmm. And let's show another one real fast.
Yeah, so this one is actually by an actress you may know, Lupita Nyong'o.
Oh, yes.
Yeah, and the reason culturally sustaining books are important for kids is we call them windows and mirrors. And we want kids to be able to see themselves in a book like a mirror, but we also want kids to be able to see other cultures and become more empathetic toward people who don't necessarily look like them. But, you know, imagine this little girl being able to look at a book and see herself in the book. So that's a beautiful new one. And then these are some science ones, which is another training we're gonna do is a science training. So helping teachers use this is about Hidden Figures. You've probably heard that nonfiction picture book, and that's about evolution and the moth, a story about natural selection. So it's gorgeous, mm-hmm. but they're also, we're giving them content. It's really exciting.
It's beautiful. And I noticed when I opened up the cover, this book was generously donated mm-hmm. by First Book in partnership, and there we are with Middle Tennessee
yes.
State University. And also, it looks like you've partnered with Lipscomb as well, and also two community groups.
Yeah, so I think the most exciting thing about this partnership is sometimes it can be easy for us to stay in our office or, you know, ivory tower, mm-hmm. you know, situation. But in education, we really, for our kids and for our teachers, we're better together, and we also have to be on the ground, in the community. So I'm really passionate about that, and I'm passionate about that we all have strengths and that we can use our strengths together. So here in Middle Tennessee, we have Read to Succeed, which has a similar mm-hmm. mission as First Book. And we have Murfreesboro City Schools right here, you know, in our town. We have Title I designated schools of kids who I've heard stories of kids here in Murfreesboro who don't have their own first book. And then, you know, just right down the road in Nashville, we have one of the most high poverty school districts in Tennessee, which is Metro Nashville Schools. And we have Lipscomb, which is another great university. And why don't we partner together?
Right.
And then also they have Bookham. So we decided let's join forces. And so I wrote the grant with all of them as my partners. And we're all committed to getting all these books out. We will hit 10,000 kids by the end of this.
Wow.
Yeah, 10,000 kids will get books in all throughout Metro Nashville schools. and all through Murfreesboro City Schools, and then teachers will also get to build up their libraries with all this money.
Why is it important that we get into these schools and as a university? What roles do we as universities play to help solve this problem, to make strides in this direction?
We have a privilege as professors to have a lot more time on our hands to research, to write these grants, to figure out what's best practices. You know, that's part of our job. But if we stay, you know, doing that up in our offices, then we don't help teachers out on the field. I think we're really committed now in the College of Education just to be in the schools with the teachers to know what it's like to be a teacher now and don't lose touch and be with kids and see their faces because that's why we do what we're doing, and not to lose sight of that kid when they open their first book or when they bring in their family and get to show and do a project together in a family literacy night and then take home books, and to see that pride and then to support teachers because they are asked to do so much. So if we can help them with training, because we're doing some professional development with this as well, you know, give them some training, give them free stuff, and then also help them with a best way to put on a literacy event that will include families.
Right.
That's really our goal.
Great segue, because I wanted to ask you about literacy events. Give me an example of what you're talking about there.
Sure. So traditionally, and what Read to Succeed has really been helping us do is a family literacy night. The parents come, caregivers, whoever, grandparents, cousins, whoever can come, and they provide dinner, and then we provide books. And we provide about 45 minutes of activities around these books.
Right.
And we want to empower them to feel like they can snuggle up with this book and they can ask the kid questions and they can bond together and learn together as a family. And there's a lot of research that home literacy environment impacts kids' reading achievement. And so we want to help parents with that because we know that they have a hard job.
Well, congratulations to you.
Thank
you. First big grant.
Yes.
and making a big difference in the lives of children here. It's really appreciated. And thanks for coming on Out of the Blue.
Thank you for having me. I appreciate it.